Hello, welcome to the Table Gamers. This is a playthrough of Civilization 4, Rise and Falls of Civilization, the Romans. I'll be going for a historical victory on Viceroy difficulty because it's just a playthrough and it's intended to give you a decent idea of how to play with Rome. Not a flawless idea, but some decent idea, hopefully. Rome is a fairly difficult historical victory to win. We're playing in double speed, by the way, to make things a bit more interesting. The first thing I do here, in order to get the historical victory point in colonizing Western Rome. So I send a settler to the left towards Spain, I think that was. Or maybe, no, that's going to England. So that city in the north will join your side. And continue moving the boats. Researching mathematics in order to get aqueducts. Might not be the best way to do things, but that's how I did it. And there was no settler village, or whatever you call them. Obviously must have been taken by Greece or something. But usually on the western side of Spain there is one. There's London. Putting on research just there so I can speed up mathematics. Not that it would help me much, but because I would first start building an aqueduct there. And there's a barracks in Rome. You need a barracks, I think it's 5 barracks, 5 aqueducts, and 5 amphitheatres, I think. I might be wrong, I can't remember. And the last historical victory point is no cities captured by barbarians until a certain point in time, which is also quite a difficult victory. Up to a point, it's not as hard as, say, colonizing all of Western Rome, which is not easy. Rome will build those buildings that you need fairly quickly, and then you can start focusing on your military might in order to invade Carthage. Some people will invade Greece at the beginning, but that's unnecessary for historical victory anyway. Anyway, those French cities will start appearing, and you can just take them rather than settling them. Will defend, but it won't be enough defense when the barbarians come. another French city taken. Paris is usually the last, is always the last one, and it takes a little while to come around. Building triremes to defend the galleys in order to invade Carthage. Slave rushing is also quite essential. I was lucky that that barbarian triumph didn't go for me. Another trireme. And there's Paris. Even though my technology rate's only gone down to 60%, it's not vital that it stays for historical victory. But it is useful. And I want catapults for the invasion as well. Now that my navy should be big enough. And he's declared war on me. So I don't have to do it for him. You can see I have a tendency to decline open borders while I'm going for historical victories in order to avoid the plague. Doesn't always help, but it does sometimes. The barbarians now start to attack. It's useful to get the Great Wall of China in Rome. And then you don't have to worry about the barbarians, but I'm not sure if I did in this game. I might have. It's not very historically accurate, but you know, if you're going for a historical victory, sometimes. Yeah, I don't even know. Usually Carthage doesn't do much in the war except attack your fishing boats, which can be a little bit annoying, but you know. Now we will mount the invasion. Now we've got some Praetorians and some catapults. We'll probably try to take out some of my ships, but that won't matter. Yes, there you go. Moving across my Praetorians, hopefully in order to defend from the barbarians that are coming up from the south. From Spain. Can be a problem if your cities aren't heavily defended enough. So there's one city, and he's got three cities, so I'm not sure whether you have to take all of the others, but you do have to control two cities in Carthage, I think it is. So, I can't remember what I did there. Let's see. That's what those Praetorians were moving west for, was to defend the city that I'm about to build in Spain. You need at least two cities in Spain to get the historical point. It's always a good idea to build the city that will be further away first rather than second. Because at the end you'll be very rushed to get that city, and if it's far away then it could be quite a pain. AD, I think that says. So, I don't have many years left to do it. But I think I have just about finished up with all the buildings that I need. And I have only two more cities to found, one of which is about to be founded, the second of which is not far away. And where those Praetorians are standing, that's where it will be. Just rush the settler, so it'll be the next turn. Now I began focusing on military in order to fend off the barbarians. Barbarians are really hitting hard in the south there, but that's okay. It should be fine. And that is the first goal. Finish right there. I think this is 1 out of 3, but I'm not sure. We'll see. I'll assume that it is. Fortunately, the terrain is very strong. And will defend your cities quite well. So there's Greece getting the plague. That is why I did not open borders with them before. Probably not the smartest idea, attacking them, but that is what I did, and I lost some troops. It's not very smart. I should probably have just sat in my cities and let them attack me. Like that. That's 2 historical victories down, 1 to go, and that's the end of the first part.